It is the 16th of August 2017, and it's time to deliver a very important lunchbox in Boruto Episode 20, The Boy, the Sharingan. And man, it's time to kick off the Shinden arc properly. Not that last week wasn't really proper, but you know what I mean. Also, I keep forgetting to say this, but spoiler warning, if you haven't seen the episode, then don't watch this if you don't want to be spoiled, obviously. And yeah, we've finally got a big bad guy. Well, we kind of have for the last episode or two, but this time we kind of have a name for them and more of a motive and stuff now. And that is in the form of the boy with the Sharingan. Oh, sorry, the boy with the Sharingan. As the title suggests, Shin. He seems pretty cool. Not much is known about him. And when I say he seems pretty cool, he's probably going to be a kind of powerful first villain who will then be defeated, and his father, or whoever he is, will take over his place for the next battle. Sounds like I'm being a little cynical here and predicting how it's going to go, but I don't know, I'm actually kind of excited and hoping it does go like that. And you know, even though they were quite brief fights, I did quite enjoy the little part with Sasuke fighting with him in the start, and then the kind of bigger fight with Naruto going full-tailed beast mode later on. And I like that they're kind of doing this, that there are little small skirmishes that are happening, the kind of build-up to the ultimate fight at the end. Or at least that's how I assume it's going to go, because this is a shonen anime. I could be wrong, of course, because so far Boruto isn't really sticking super close to the stereotypical shonen story type. It's happy to spend a couple of episodes just fleshing out character story and interaction and stuff. And so far, up until this point, there really hasn't been one central bad guy, apart from that time that class rep kind of started possessing people, but that only lasted an episode, so. And you know, a lot happened this episode, but not a lot either. There was a lot of small, quick scenes that kind of bled into each other, which I liked, because it really is building a little bit of tension. And I like that we got to see a little bit of Kakashi just hanging out on his break at the bathhouse. I have a feeling he'll probably play into it later, because we did see during the whole ghost arc that Kakashi's got that new purple lightning kind of attack. And I reckon the reason they showed that is to kind of build it up and to hype people so that when he is involved in this fight later on, people will be looking forward to it more. And even though the whole episode, and basically the start of this whole arc, is about Sarada, I was pleasantly surprised to see how much time they gave to Naruto. Not only the small fight sequence where he shows up and shows off that he's still got it and stuff, but when he just relaxed and talked to everyone, and that was really cool. I really like seeing older Naruto. He's become a lot more humble, but he's still his old goofy self as well. And then now, the kind of weird pairing of Sarada and Chocho just hanging around with Naruto is really weird, but a really interesting kind of dynamic too. And much like that episode where it was mainly about Denki and Iwabe, I will give them props that this is another episode, only 20 episodes into the series, where Boruto barely featured. He kind of showed up for about 2 minutes, and that is it. And I really like that. This isn't some kind of, oh, Boruto is the greatest, let's always focus on Boruto kind of thing. There seems to be a really big emphasis on world building and character building, which is really nice. Obviously, the character building is mainly focused on Sarada and Naruto, two main characters. But all the same, it is really cool, and hopefully, when they do join as a team, we'll get to actually know stuff about Sarada before she joins the team, rather than kind of explaining it through teamwork later on and stuff. And overall, that was just a pretty darn good start to the Shinden arc. I'm really looking forward to seeing more of Shin and his father. And also just more of Sasuke, because they've done a really clever thing here, which is given us very brief bits of story and very small scenes involving Sasuke as a kind of teaser to get people pumped for seeing him again. And man, what a way to end the episode. I know this is going to be instantly resolved next episode, but just the fact that Sasuke threatened Sarada because he didn't even know what she looked like. And, of course, because she'd activated the Sharingan, but that was really cool. I liked that little touch. And, you know, I don't talk about this much, but the cinematography of this series, I find, is pretty cool. They've got some interesting angles and some kind of arty-feeling scenes. Overall, this is definitely a step up from especially some episodes of Shippuden that felt like they were just doing it through obligation, that they didn't really care what the animation was like or anything, just that it kind of puddled along. Is puddled even a real word? What do I mean? I'm talking about being resolved next time. It is time to discuss
next time.
And it's not shocking. Next time is just a continuation of what is happening now. Hopefully with more of an escalation. And I think it looks like Sasuke goes to the realm where the Otsutsuki people are. Actually, that's a point. Are they Otsutsuki? I assume they are. They've got the Sharingan and stuff. But they're not Uchiha, right? Or are they? I don't know. As I've said previously, I don't read the manga and I don't really read much about Boruto. So there could be something very obvious here that I'm just missing out on. And that about wraps it up for my review of episode 20 of Boruto. It's been a bit of a quick one. I haven't had all that much to say, really. Because while a lot happened, they could all be summarised into 2 or 3 points, really. So I'm going to end it here. If you did enjoy this episode, then please subscribe. You will be notified when the next review of next week's episode goes up, along with other views I have planned for the future, along with my journey through the Gundam series. I'll leave a link at the end if that does interest you. And as always, leave a comment if you feel like there's something I've missed, or you'd like to add something, or you'd like to advertise your Instagram page, which is the recurring comment I've gotten on my last 3 videos now, and I don't know why, really. And talking about Instagram, if you do want to follow me on social media, the links are below in the description. And until next time,
goodbye!